I'm sort of in the middle of like moving right now, which is why it's kind of crazy, and I've been a little bit delayed with making some of my videos for you guys. But I got the request to actually do a video about what's going to happen with the Milky Way galaxy when it collides with our neighbor, the Andromeda galaxy. It's a huge spiral galaxy, about 4 times bigger than the Milky Way, and I thought I would do a little video on it. So, in about 4 billion years from now, we're actually going to be colliding. So what this actually means is it's not going to be like a insane, like kaboom. It's not going to be like an instant moment. It's going to be a very gradual process, because what's happening is you have two very strong areas where there's gravity, really very, very strong bodies of gravity, and that is the central regions of each galaxy. So you have the Milky Way galaxy that is rotating, you have the Andromeda galaxy that's rotating, and they're slowly starting to rotate towards each other. They're feeding off of each other's gravity, so they're kind of doing a little dance. But what's happening, since Andromeda is significantly larger than the Milky Way galaxy, its gravitational pull is so much stronger than ours that it's actually pulling us in little by little each year. So it's gonna be about 4 billion years from now, so like we're actually pretty good, because we may actually either be gone by then or would have already established some form of interstellar travel. But a good thing is that our sun is actually still going to be around, and it's probably going to survive this collision. And why is that? Well, most galaxies, there is a lot of stuff in it, like there is a lot of stars and there's a lot of planets, but most of it actually is empty space or just dark space where we can't actually see what's there. And that's where the theory of dark matter comes in, a lot of observations of dark matter comes in. But the thing is, a lot of it is just like dust and gas, and that which would be like different nebulae and stuff like that. So when it's actually colliding, a lot of times regions and areas where there actually is physical matter, like stars and planets, they actually will kind of just be interacting with the space around it, because there is so much empty space. So I guess a really good way to think about this would be like, if you're in a whirlpool, or say you're in a big swimming pool and you're with your friends, and you know, like that game when like everyone kind of hangs out around the rim of the swimming pool, but you're inside and you're spinning to try and create a whirlpool. So you have like 5 or 6 people, you're all sort of like going in a circle, and then one of them just, I don't know, they slip a little bit and then they kind of just fall and they move with the current. Occasionally they may collide with another person, but there's more room in the swimming pool of just water than there is of other people. So let's say that the people are stars and that the water is either the empty space or the dust and gas in the galaxy. So what's going to happen is that person that kind of like slipped, there's a higher chance that they'll just kind of keep going with the current and they'll start merging with the whirlpool that's formed. Or occasionally it is possible they might have a collision with another person. But that's, you know, a much smaller probability. So this is exactly what's happening with our planets and our stars in our galaxy, is that most of the time there may be a few collisions here and there, but most of it is just, there's gonna be a lot of gravitational interactions. So the Andromeda galaxy is estimated to be about 220,000 light years across, where the Milky Way galaxy is just about 100,000 light years across. And again, I've said this in my videos before, what I mean by a light year as a distance is literally what it sounds like. The amount of time that it takes light to travel in 1 year. So it's gonna take 100,000 years for light to go from one end of the Milky Way galaxy to the other end, and for the Andromeda galaxy, it's gonna take about 220,000 years for light to go from one end to the other end of the Andromeda galaxy.
Lastly, this is a really cool simulation video that I just watched on the YouTube channel, The Bad Astronomer, of what it's actually gonna look like when the Milky Way galaxy is gonna collide with the Andromeda galaxy. So the link is actually in the caption below. You guys should totally watch that right after this. But yeah, so that's pretty much what's gonna happen. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys next time. And leave a comment below of a subject you guys might want me to talk about next time. Okay, bye guys.